study about an important compound that is vitamin B12. It is also known as cobalamine or cyanocobalamin. It is a very important naturally occurring organometallic compound. What are organometallic compounds? The compound that possess a direct carbon to metal bond. It means any compound which has a direct carbon to metal bond will be called organometallic compound. And a vitamin B12 is a good example of such type of compounds. And it is the only vitamin that contains the metal. No other vitamin possesses metal. It is synthesized by microorganisms or anaerobic bacteria, and it is found in vivo. It means inside the tissues, inside the animals and the humans. It is not found in the plants, and it is not isolated from plants. It is firstly isolated from the liver, and it is found in vivo. It is not found outside. It is a coenzyme and it acts as a prosthetic group. What is prosthetic group? Any group that can bind the several enzymes in the body act as a prosthetic group. And vitamin B12 is a good example of prosthetic group because it can bind several enzymes and hence it enhances several reactions. It is like the Grignard reagent in which can provide a base for several reactions to take place. Several reagents can add to Grignard reagents and several reactions take place. And hence the vitamin B12 also act like this, and hence it is known as the biological Grignard reagent. Now we come to the structure of the vitamin B12. Vitamin B12 is the complex of cobalt. So there is a cobalt ion in the center of this molecule. The cobalt is in the +3 oxidation state, and it is surrounded by a ring. That is a corine ring. It is not a porphyrin ring. It is a corine ring. And what is the difference between the corine ring and the porphyrin ring? It is similar to the porphyrin ring, but it has missing one CH group. Here there is a CH group, but here this is missing. And this is the corine ring. We have denoted it by red color for your understanding. And there are 4 pyrrole molecules in this ring, and the nitrogen atom of the pyrrole rings are coordinated to the cobalt atom, cobalt ion, and hence the 4 coordination positions are occupied by the 4 nitrogens of the pyrrole ring. There are several substituents present at the periphery of this corine ring. These are the substituents that are present at the periphery of this corine ring. And at the one periphery, there is a complex chain. This is the complex chain. This consists of 3 parts: a phosphate group, a sugar molecule, and a base. This is the chain. This is the phosphate group. This is the sugar molecule, and this is the base. This is nitrogenous base, that is α5,6-dimethylbenzimidazole. The nitrogen atom of this base is coordinated to the cobalt ion, and it is occupying the 5th coordination position of the cobalt ion. The 6th position of the cobalt ion remains vacant in the naturally occurring vitamin B12, and it is occupied according to the need of the body as the reaction takes place. When we isolate the vitamin B12, a cyanide group is added at this position artificially, and we get cyanocobalamin. But in naturally occurring vitamin B12, there is no cyanide group present at this position. Now we see the component of vitamin B12 in short. It means there is a centered cobalt third ion that is present in the center, a corine ring surrounding this cobalt ion. That is a CH group missing from the porphyrin ring, and a complex chain that consists of a phosphate group, a sugar molecule, and a base. So the four coordination position of cobalt are occupied by four nitrogen of the coordinate rings. The fifth coordination position of cobalt is occupied by the nitrogen of alpha 5,6 dimethyl benzimidazole. And the sixth position of cobalt that is vacant in natural vitamin B12 is occupied by cyanide in the cyanocobalamin, that is the isolated form in the laboratory, by the hydroxyl group in the hydroxocobalamin, and the methyl group in methylcobalamin. Now we come to the functions of the vitamin B12. In the presence of ATP, it is converted to coenzyme B12. This is vitamin B12. In the presence of ATP, the cyanide group is removed and deoxyadenosine is added at this position. Now this coenzyme B12 takes part in several biological processes. The one of the important processes is the conversion of methyl malonyl coenzyme A to succinyl coenzyme A. Second important process is the isomerization of dicarboxylic acid. For example, the conversion of glutamic acid to beta methyl aspartic acid takes place in the presence of coenzyme B12. Another important process is the dismutation of vicinal diols to the corresponding aldehydes. An example of this type of reaction is the conversion of propane 1,2 diol to propionaldehyde. Another important process is the methylation of homocysteine to methionine. So these are some of the functions of vitamin B12. And what happens when it is deficiency of vitamin B12? Its deficiency causes the pernicious anemia. This is due to the decreased production of the red blood corpuscles. And this causes effect in the central nervous system. So this is all about the vitamin B12 as according to the syllabus of CSIR NET. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel, please comment, and thank you.